Okay, welcome to the London Media Lounge studios, and we are joined today by Phil G. Hi, Phil.
Hi, Steve.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Thank you for inviting me on your podcast.
Now, you are a social media guru, social media trainer, a coach, a mentor, all of those things.
Correct.
How did you sort of start off in your sort of career? I was just doing a bit of spying on LinkedIn. There's a story about Lee Cooper and selling, I guess, jeans initially.
Yeah, that's right.
Was that one of your first jobs?
Yeah, that was one of my last jobs, to be honest, before I became self-employed.
Ah.
From leaving school, I went straight into retail. So I did retail for 20 years, which included Marks & Spencer's and a few other brands, high street brands. Lee Cooper was one of them.
And Black's Leisure is in there, so camping and stuff, outdoor things.
Camping, outdoor, hiking. Yeah, walking, it was a world that isn't me at all, Steve, to be honest with you. So that was a bit of an education for me.
And then there's 4 years at Gosh Shoes.
Yes.
What's that all about?
So Gosh Shoes was after I decided to leave employment, I went into self-employment. So it was my first voyage into self-employment. And because I'd been in retail, worked in fashion, and I decided to open a shoe shop.
Of course.
So the brand became Gosh, which was actually my wife at the time and our three children. It's their initials. It's spelled Gosh.
Ah.
And also because the place where it was, which is a suburb of Liverpool, hadn't had a shoe shop for about 20 years. So it was a bit like, Gosh, a shoe shop. That was it. So that was ladies' shoes, men's shoes, children's shoes. So yeah, so I did that for 4 years and I really, really enjoyed it.
But now you run Agency of Boom.
Correct.
And also Social Media Academy.
That's right.
So let's start with Agency of Boom. What's all that about? So
Agency of Boom has been trading for 15 years. That actually started from the shoe shop. I was having a website made for my shoe shop. Which really excited me. And after a troubling year in retail, I decided to make the jump from retail to online because I really, really enjoyed. I was trading on eBay
at
the very beginning. So that's, and I just thought the guy who was helping me to build the website, I got on very well with, and I said to him, listen, maybe we should go into business. I can sell the websites. He can build them. And so we set up. That was 15 years ago.
So we're talking probably GIFs and almost MySpace time.
It was.
I remember Bebo. MySpace. Yeah. There's a lot of those things that have fallen by the wayside,
and,
aren't there?
And at the time, which is what I say to a lot of our customers, is that, you know, MySpace at the time had the monopoly on social media. There was that and Friends Reunited.
Oh, yes.
Do you remember Friends Reunited?
Yeah.
And at the time, everyone was on MySpace. It was absolutely smashing it. And then all of a sudden, boom, it was just gone.
Mm.
You know, and then Facebook came along, and obviously Twitter, and then Instagram, and so on and so forth. So, so websites was the initial step into digital marketing. Obviously, social media didn't exist at the time, but we were under pressure as web designers to drive traffic to website. Then Facebook came around. We just thought, I wonder if we can utilize that to help our clients to get traffic, which it did. And the interest in the Facebook side of the business sort of overtook the website at one point. So that was about 8 years ago. So I decided to sort of, you know, jump on that as best we could, built a team around that. And mainly through networking, built up, you know, decent trade from that. So now we can offer web, social media, email marketing, and all the other peripheral services that come with it. So I run that with got a business partner who joined 4 years ago, Rob. He's in Liverpool, I'm in London, so we've got north and south now. And so that's Agency of Boom.
And then Social Media Academy, that's something else.
Yeah.
So you train people.
Yeah, so that's sort of, it was something I was doing on a one-to-one basis for clients pre-pandemic. But obviously pandemic hit, online training became the in thing because people had all this time on their hands. So the first week of lockdown, I thought I need to, I need to explore the potential of this. I mean, one of our, on the agency of Boom, one of our biggest clients is McDonald's, which I love name dropping. I had to throw that into the conversation. So we work on a franchise level. We don't work for the McDonald's UK. We work for different franchisees around the UK.
Mm.
And obviously, at the beginning of lockdown, McDonald's, all the food outlets, caps closed down. So we were put on hold for a few months. So just, I wouldn't say boredom, but just trying to find things to do. The first week of lockdown, I thought, I'm going to do an online training. So I advertised it. I learned Zoom within like a couple of hours. I'd heard of Zoom, but I'd never used it. And bought the webinar version and launched it. I think it was week two of lockdown. I think it was the first week of April. Had 25 people turn up. It was a free 5-day social media extravaganza, shall we say. And from that, the majority of them then said, you know, can you train us on a one-to-one level kind of thing? So that's where that brand sort of came from. I'd had the brand name ready anyway, but it was one of those domain names that I never thought I'd use, really, or I didn't know whether I would. And that's it. So that's been 2.5 years with Social Media Academy. So that's training CEOs, directors, business owners on how to understand social media, how to get the best out of it for their business, how to use it for themselves as a business owner on LinkedIn and Twitter. And also if they have a team, if they have a staff member that they want to do their social media, they've got to understand the dynamics of social media before they can instruct their member of staff how to do it for them.
So you hear stories of the, for example, the receptionist being given the social media accounts. And yes. That's not the best thing to do, perhaps, I guess.
I think the mindset is, especially for a lot of business owners, is that young people get social media.
Yep.
But that's not always the case. They might be able to technically do it, but have they got a business brain, the business acumen? Have they got a marketing experience or the knowledge to really push their brand forward? So they're the kind of people that we can train. They might have somebody who's eager, who knows how to do Facebook and Instagram, but might not understand Twitter and LinkedIn or YouTube, so on and so forth.
I like that plan because I worry slightly when companies outsource their social media to other companies. I mean, in that case, I don't know how you make sure that you're speaking the language of that company in all the posts. It might be quite technical, for example. If you've outsourced it, are you going to obviously to outsiders appear like an alien to that industry because you just can't speak the language?
Well, on the agency of Boom side, so where we do the full management for clients, we obviously need to spend time at the beginning to understand their business as best we can. But I mean, being honest with you, in an ideal world, the company would manage their own social media. It's just that a lot of our customers, they're either too busy or they haven't got the resources to employ a member of staff.
Yeah.
Because with social media being 24/7, and that's what we offer. So for a company to find a member of staff, they'd need more than one to cover 7 days and seven nights. And the cost implications of that would be astronomic. So for a fraction of the cost, we can manage it for them.
I suppose you can respond, though, if you're running 24/7, you can respond to events that are happening and put a funny post out or a topical post out related to something that I saw one recently after the, I forget the awards ceremony, but there was Anne Marie, who the pop star fell over during the awards ceremony. And then she was fine. And then later on, Specsavers posted, your next visit's on us. I thought that was just classic because they've obviously, they're trying to get their brand across, but also in a funny and topical way.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. And that's the kind of thing that you know, for one person to do it, they've got to have that kind of mindset and brain that can sort of see something that happens topical today. And think, how can they relate that to their business? And also, it's about the speed. Yeah, I mean, we have the news on in our offices all the time. So if anything happens topical, you know, straight away we're thinking, which clients is that relevant to? What can we do? How can we promote them through that?
Mm.
So it's really just being finger on the pulse and getting it done as quickly as possible.
And networking as well, the value of networking. I've seen that as I've started running this business, meeting various local networking groups, yeah. and people of normally are quite helpful. They kind of, you know, recommend you to other people in the networking group. Have you got any networking tips, maybe? I mean, at this point, we must shout out Piyush Patel, because he put us together.
Definitely.
The kind of, he's a Federation of Small Business Advisor, but he's a genius on LinkedIn, permanently yep. putting people together. What a guy.
I've only known of Piyush for 2 weeks now. I feel yep. as though I've known him for 2 years or a lot longer. And he's a funny guy. I'm looking forward to collaborating with him on events. I mean, I actually run my own event in Liverpool. So I've run that for about 7 years, networking. So I'm yep. a massive, massive lover and believer of networking. I don't know about love is the right word, but you know, definitely, yeah, I can see the benefits of it. Tips, if you're asking me for tips, I would say go to as many events as you can do. Don't give up. Like anything, you've got to persevere with it. Don't go there with the intention of selling. Just go there with the intention of meeting people.
Yeah.
And that's why if you can find a group that you feel comfortable in and that you can return on a regular basis and build relationships with the people. I don't think it's not often, unless you're lucky to be in the right place at the right time, that someone is looking for your services on that day, then I think that the value really comes from building relationships with business people who you can then refer people to them and maybe get some referrals in return.
It's quite a challenge, isn't it, being a networking host, I think, because it's getting that balance right. Sometimes they have speakers that come in and do presentations, which can be quite useful. But other times I think just the host is almost the sort of like a party almost. You're putting yeah. people together. Oh, you might be interested in meeting so-and-so. I'll get you together to
yeah, definitely.
To chat or whatever.
Definitely. I mean, one of the things that I've noticed is that as the host, you know, obviously I've got, you know, my businesses that I run, but people who come to my events see me as an event organizer.
Yeah.
And so the conversation I'm having with them is to try and find out about them, and like you said, to match them with people in the room that might be of assistance to them, or they might be able to have a good relationship together. But people don't often ask me what actually I do for a living.
Yeah.
So I'm facilitating a room full of people all swapping business cards, and I'm just there in the corner just making sure that everything runs accordingly.
Let's have a look at your websites. Social media coach, trainer, and mentor. This is your training site.
Yes, that's Social Media Academy.
So on here, what sort of things can we learn? So various courses.
Yeah. So we've got basically entry level, which is mainly for my clients that I do one to one. Obviously, we do coaching, but for them to remember everything in the one session is just not going to happen.
Yeah.
So that enables them then to go back. They can log in and they can just look on all the things that we've spoken about, either by video or in Word format.
I love the caricatures. You've obviously got some very clever cartoonist.
It's trying to find the right one to fit in with the right topic.
Yep. So you've got training, management and networking events.
Yes.
Generation of leads, and these are some of the clients you've worked with.
Yeah.
Some major names in there.
Yeah.
McDonald's. And then the other one, Agency of Boom. This yeah. is this side.
So that's the management side.
Yeah. And you become their marketing team, basically.
Yeah, exactly.
That's great. I like that idea. And here we have...
There's our little team.
Yeah, the team.
And the best looking of the bunch, I reckon.
I think on the hair stakes, you're...
Yeah. Actually, the picture of Rob is from about 20 years ago, but he insists on keeping that. He doesn't look like that now.
Well, that's great. Thanks for giving us a flavour of what you do, Phil. That's amazing.
And no problem at all.
A new life down here in Chiswick now.
Yeah.
From Liverpool.
Yeah, enjoying it very much.
Probably a bit more expensive renting a house, though.
A little bit, yeah.
Probably get a mansion in Liverpool for
definitely
what you're paying in Chiswick. Definitely. I don't know.
Oh, no, I mean, I have that conversation quite regularly with people that I meet over there. You know, I mean, how people, I don't know, it's just it's a different world down here. You know, for, I mean, the prices of the houses are like 10 times more expensive down here in some cases.
You were in Southport, you were saying, which is that was a seaside town.
Yeah, it's very nice, yeah.
Beach and whatever.
Yeah, beach, pine woods. Yeah, very nice.
Nice.
Nice sea air.
Great. Agencyofboom.com and then Social Media Academy.
.uk.
.uk. .co.uk. Yep. Thanks for coming in, Phil. That's great.
Lovely. And if anyone wants to follow, I'm on all social medias, Online Guru UK.
Online Guru UK. Yes, that's your LinkedIn URL.
Yes.
Your handle. Yeah. All right. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you very much, Steve. Thank you.